Hi guys, and welcome back to more Dark Souls 3 New Game Plus with me, beaktastic. So, last time, we took out the Nameless King, with a little bit of help, admittedly, which I still feel slightly bad about, but like I said, I've done it before, I can't be bothered to sit for like 12 hours or whatever and beat the Nameless King on my own. It wouldn't take 12 hours, but you know what I mean, guys. Sit there and fight him endlessly to do it. Because I've done it before. I gave it a good go, and I got really, really close, so I know I could have done it, but whatever. Anyway, we've got one or two last things we want to run and take care of in Firelink before we progress on. How may... So first of all, we've got some Umbral Ash to give her. Let the Ionic. And then we can buy some more embers, which is good because I used it so many last time. Let's buy some of this because that was actually kind of useful. I've got some of those, got plenty of those. We can now buy titanite scales from her since I've given her those ashes, so my titanite scale issues are over. Now that I already have like a bajillion, how many titanite scales do I have? I already have 38, so I've got loads, but my titanite worries are over. So it's fine. I think I've got all of those, so I'm not gonna concern myself too much with any of that. Okay. Action one. Oh. In between episodes, I'd already also kind of reallotted my Estus back once again, switched up my weapons once again. Although, actually, what I wanted to look at, which I didn't look at, is I wanted to look at switching out my spells for that. Oh, I need 25. 25, because I was like, that could have been quite cool to play around with. Guys. Oh, I need to raise my intelligence up by like 10. And then I could always maybe switch out a weapon. I could always raise it by 5 and then switch out a ring. Okay, I'm gonna leave it for now. I may do that, but for now. I'm gonna leave it. What I will do is we're just gonna quickly chat to Ludlith. And we're gonna have a look at what we can transpose in the Nameless King's soul. So first of all, we can get Lightning Storm, which is a miracle, which calls forth furious bolts of lightning. Once a slayer of dragons, the former king and war god tamed a storm drake on which he led a lifetime of battle. This miracle is likely a tale of their bond. Alternatively, we can get the Storm Curved Sword, which I think is what what I got last time, which is a curved sword imbued with the strength of the Storm Drake. The Nameless King, ally of the ancient dragons, fought beside the Storm Drake in countless battles. When the great beast fell, the king claimed his soul, as was the custom in the Age of Gods. Or finally, we can get the Dragon Slayer Sword Spear, which is really cool, and I kind of want it. I wish I had gotten that last time. The dragon hunting weapon from the Age of the Gods, the earliest form of the cross spear, serving as both sword and spear. Its owner was the Nameless King and deific hunter of dragons. The sword spear is imbued with lightning, of which he was the heir. This kind of tells us that he was Gwyn's exiled son, pretty much. I do want that, but no. I need to get the miracle. I could do some save loading but it's just going to be a pain at the end. Well, it won't be too much of a pain, but no. We're gonna get Lightning Storm, which is one of the final miracles that I need, so now I only need one more to get my miracle wand for my platinum. So that'll be good. And then one other thing, I think actually that's everything we want to do here for now. One thing I realise, because I keep seeing Leonard there, is if we go back to... That's the wrong one. Go back to here. There's something we can do, guys. First of all, after that little pop-in, there's two things here. There's a nice sluggy slug. They won't attack us, and you can kind of get a good, really good look at them. It's really, really quite disgusting. You kill it, and you get Hazel stuff, so that's suggested to be Hazel after having transformed. But also... Oh, she's not... Don't think I did it before. I was expecting it to be dead. Huh, I must have missed something else. Oh well. Never mind then. What we'll do then is we're going to go and we're going to get the DLC bit done. I don't need to do the DLC for my platinum, but I'm going to be... I plan on recording the second DLC when it comes out, so I might as well record the first one since we're here. And now seems a good time to do it to get everything else wrapped up because I've been everywhere else, I think. I don't think there's anything else really I need to do.
My very own home now. Oh.
So, that is the guy that we saw last time, who was in here. Pretty sure it's him anyway.
Quick, a sweet.
Yep. Yeah, I thought he died or something, but no, he just says that when you come back to this bonfire. Fair enough. Anyway, right. We're going to progress and get this DLC wrapped up. I say wrapped up. I haven't even started the DLC on this playthrough. We're going to come and do the DLC. Now that tree is not alive, fair enough. I'm going to come over here and take out this guy. Disgusting insect thing. Guarding a poison gem. And if we wander over here. On the one hand, I really like this kind of snowfieldy area. Because it's really, really cool. It's nice having like a really wintry area. But on the other hand, it's like impossible to see, which I think is obviously the point, but. Ooh, someone's awake. Fuck. Ah, my battery's dying. This is like the worst time for my battery to be dying. Okay, we'll take out these guys and I'll switch. Or plug this in or whatever. Oh, for God's sake. You're dead. Is there another one? Did I get you all? I think I got you all. I should freaking that, right. Yeah, I think I got you all here, so. Yep, I seem to. Okay. So, oh look! Look at that item just lying in the middle of this snowfield! And oh my god! Yeah, guys. Now this area is just a bit of a pain. See all these frozen bodies. Just lying there. doggies. Stop it! Right, I think that's all of these walls. Okay, we got them. We got them all. Well, all of those ones. There's more over there. And there's a slightly giant one over there. I killed the wolf there, so it's not going to reappear for me there anymore, which is good. It's kind of what I wanted, to do at this point in time. Okay. So now... Checking for items. It's so hard to see items in this landscape. I feel like I've missed items, but it's like impossible to tell, pretty much. I don't think there's anything massively important, I think it's just like moss clumps and that kind of thing. Okay, and then we've got a whole bunch of guys here, so let's see if I can either lure them or take them out kind of one by one. Sweet, okay, so that's one. He's dead. And then now I can happily come and take out this guy. Didn't really mean for it to a dodge attack that way, but oh well. And we get his javelin as a treat. Okay. I'm trying to decide where I want to go next, because I could go that way, but I'll probably get beat. So we're going to go back up this way, have a quick scout over here for items on our travels. All of the wolves that are killed. Doesn't look like I've missed any items, but I probably have. Oh, fuck. Back up from the trees for a bit. And all the stupid fire. Fuck. Come on, Wolfie. Oh, fuck. That was close. That nearly ended horribly. Fucking hell, man, these trees. Those trees are like really brutal. There are another wolf. There is. Let's see if I can either kill or lure that wolf over here. Okay. Freaking more trees. I think only one of them's actually an enemy, though. Out of those two, anyway. Oh my god, the trees can move! I didn't know the trees could actually walk. And the bug's just sliding down the hill. You can tell which ones are going to move because their hair actually moves, whereas the ones who aren't going to move, the hair is like static. Like that. So if you're playing this and you're having trouble kind of distinguishing, you know. And there's one or two more bugs, so I'm going to come back over here and see if I can surprise them. Might end horribly, guys, but Geronimo! Frozen weapon, sweet. Head down this way, guys. And I can't remember where I want to be going. Do I want to be going this way? Nope, because this is a dead end for this way. Okay. Ah, yeah, no, this is the way that I want to be going. Because if we come up here, the real money shop. And you can see there's a bonfire here, but very clever people can notice that if you come up here, there's like a little hole where you can see the bonfire, which is quite clever. I'm not quite sure why you need the hole. But, oh well. Anyway, we're going to light the bonfire. And do I want to rest? Yeah, because actually where I'm going to be going, if I don't rest, then I'll probably get annihilated. That first bit's done at least, so can I wander over this way? can, but it leads me nowhere. I'm going to want to go back up that hill and make a bit of a mad dash. So this may end horribly, guys, because I've never actually really done it from this way. I usually come from the other way. So we'll see how this ends up. Waking up every single wolf in existence, so yeah, this is clearly not the best way that I could have gone. Hopefully some of them are gonna stop chasing me soon! Right, anyway, they're still here, are dying. Which is a lot of them. You fall off that ledge. Right. Grab that. Yeah, that was clearly the way, not the way I quite should have gone, but oh well. Oh well, guys. We made it work. But there are 1,000,000,005 Millwood Knights over here instead. Okay, so I really want to get up that tower this episode. Really. Which may be easier said than done. Especially since there is an archer up there who I can see who wants to just wreck my life. I may even just make a bit of a mad dash for that tower. Do a wide skirt around that Millwood Knight and his wolf so as not to aggro them. I don't know how many times that guy has killed me. Right. So now we need to carefully try and climb this tower. To take out the guy up the top. As we're climbing, you can see a little crystal lizard there, guys, that we'll try and get in a bit. You can hear. Hang on. Because there's a very good chance of falling. No idea where that guy is, so let's try and carefully climb up. Okay. Hey! Sweet! I've never actually done that with the silver cat ring kind of dropping, plunging, attack method. That actually is a pretty solid method, I would say, of actually taking him out. Because obviously you have to fight him on such a narrow, kind of decrepit tower platform. So... doing that actually gives you a pretty solid way of killing him. I'm here, Crystal Lizard. Twinkling Titanite. Okay. Do, 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 do. Climbing back up this tower. Okay. Was there anything else in that other level? Let's have a quick check. Because, yeah, there was. I thought there was. The ethereal oak shield. Okay. I'll continue climbing the tower. Carefully jump over that. And then we can just roll back onto there. And then if we come out here... go up, 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 up. And we can pick up the old hand there. And carefully... we have the captain's ashes. Now I think there's a couple other items dotted around that area, but... I'm just going to do this since I've got my silver cat ring on. But there's nothing of great importance, I don't think. And you have to fight past like a bajillion Millwood Knights to get there. So, oh god. I keep forgetting I have my silver cat ring on. It's like, sad and just Dark Souls baby. It's like, don't let yourself die. So what I'm going to do, actually, because I've got a lot of souls. Is if I come and I just have a little peeky peek. Shit. Coming up here. Fuck. Yes, I am totally running away from these guys. I do not want to fight them in this tower. Because I want to now see if I can get like a nice plunging attack on them. If you won't leave me alone. Where is he? Where are you, buddy? I can hear you, I just can't see you. Where are you? Where the fuck is he? Oh, he's there. Nah, I'm totally gonna cheese him. Where the fuck did that wolf come from? I like that he's just become like my little human pincushion. Why is this little wolf gone? Oh, there's wolves down there. I don't mind trying to face his wolf, because his wolf's a lot easier than he is. Where is he? Where did the wolf go? Did the wolf go back outside? The wolf may have gone outside. Oh yeah, there's the wolf. You might want to come inside the tower to face me, little wolfie. I don't want to battle that guy. I don't really want to, but... There's two more over there now. I can't be bothered. So what I am going to do... I'm going to run up here. Because we're going to have another encounter with this guy who's going to help us. Which is going to help us in a little while. And die. Right. So that's quite nice for later on because that's going to help us out a bit then. That is going to make that collapse, so I don't want to go that way. We're going to go a different way. I'm going to carefully try and sneak over this way. That's more friggin' trees. Stupid flyer. Flyer? Fire. Shit. He's seen me. You're trying to do it to me, mate, so I'm just going to do it back to you. Oh, so he's dead. Here's something stomping around. I think it's a wolf down there or something. Sweet! So we can get the Millwood Great Bow from him, Titanite Shards, and more Titanite Shards! And I think... Is it there? That just leads me to where those wolves and things are. Otherwise, I think I'm done in this area for now, so... Which bonfire is that going to take me to? Is that going to take me to the one I lit, or is that going to take me to the one right at the beginning? Oh no, it has taken me back to this one. Okay, so I've just realised I had that on. I forgot to put that on ages ago. Let's switch that back quickly. Right, okay, so guys, we're going to wrap this episode there. We've cleared out the beginning area of Painted World of Ariandel. I was kind of hoping this would only be like 2 episodes, but I think it's probably going to be a few by the time we work our way past and through everything. I'm trying to decide what I want to do first, slash next, slash whatever. Okay, either way, I'll figure that out before the next episode, but thanks for tuning in, guys. Thanks for watching another episode of my Dark Souls 3 New Game Plus run. I will catch you all later.